Hello, everyone. I know this is quite a surprise event, last minute. Any case, I was going to be coming through Barcelona, so I thought it's a good opportunity if we could have an event, and so the last minute we threw it together. But today also happens to be the shortest day and the official start of the winter. So I was thinking today, how nice, maybe I can leave you with some warmth so that through this winter, it maybe won't be so cold. Because as there are the seasons, there are seasons in life. There are seasons in each day. And the most important thing is to preserve the integrity of what is important. That is the warmth. To be in touch with it, with what it means to be alive. To understand the value of every day. One thing I was thinking about is this word opportunity. And I use it quite a bit. Oh, what an opportunity it is. But then I realized that I can't use that word. I shouldn't be using that word. And why? Because I cannot tell anyone that this is an opportunity. Because opportunity is something that the individual, the person, has to recognize. Somebody can't come along and tell you that. Is something good? I can say it's good. But do you know it's good? There is this fruit in Malaysia. It's called durian. And it's really weird because you go into hotels and they have signs, you know, no durian. Cannot bring durian here. Can't eat durian here. And so there's distinctly two sets of people. Those who absolutely like durian. And somebody who travels with me adores it. He, whenever he goes there, he has to have it. And then there's other people who cannot even tolerate the smell of it. So how can somebody convince the other one, hey, it's okay, it's good? No, this is a personal experience. This is a personal taste. And so it is in this life of what that peace is. Do you, I mean, somebody to come along and sing the praises of peace is great, fine. But do you feel the peace? That's the issue. I came across a quote, and it said, sometimes it is the eyes that make a person blind. Of course, you know, that's a good quote. So immediately I wrote it down on my iPad. It is the eyes, the very thing that are responsible for seeing when they don't see, you have blindness. And so it behooves that. Sometimes it is the ears that makes a person deaf. And it is the inability to express that makes a person mute. And it is the inability to understand the direction that a person should move in that makes a person lame. And that person who has lost all hope, all understanding, all clarity, is as good as dead. He lives, he breathes, but there's nothing there. No comprehension. No hope. Now, it's pretty intense, but it's interesting. And why is it interesting? Because the very things that we think are the ones that are responsible, our sight, this is what allows us. But when we don't see anymore the reality, then we become blind. I'm not taking it in terms of eyes per se, but the eyes' ability to see. The eyes might be perfect, but you have lost the ability to see. If you lose the ability to see, you are. If you lose the ability to comprehend, to listen, you are. If you lose the hope, if you lose the understanding, if you lose the clarity, you are. If you have no direction, nowhere to go, you are. That's the bad news. The good news is this, that you always have the ability to see. Even without the eyes. And you have the ability to hear even without these ears. And even when all sense of direction is lost, there is an inner compass pointing the way. Pointing the way. That when You have lost all hope. There is a ocean, not a puddle, not a lake, not a well, not a river, but an ocean of hope within you. If you remember nothing, just remember this part. It'll make the cold, cold winter very, very warm. You know, the problem with the world and peace is this. You're sitting in a room and you're waiting for a very important guest. And the person who is with you says yes, and the guest will come through that door. The guest will come through that door. And you're sitting there. Guess where you're looking at? And when the guest you are waiting for appears and is standing next to you, since you don't actually know what the guest looks like, guess where your attention is? And when the guest taps you on the shoulder, how do you see it? How do you view it? Stop it. I'm doing something very important. I am waiting for you to come through there. Because that's my expectation. So people want peace in their lives. And you have been told what the formula is, haven't you? In one way or the other way, it happens through there, it happens through there, it comes from there, it comes from there, and you go over there, you do this, you do that, live a chaste life. I mean, you know, I have browsed through scriptures. And sometimes it looks like a list of everything you shouldn't do. But my question is, how did they come up with that list? I mean, how? And I know exactly how, because that's exactly what the people were doing. That's exactly what the people were doing, and so then somebody comes along and said, don't do that, don't do that, and don't do that. And they're still working it out, what it is people are supposed to be doing and not doing, even to this day. Because people are still doing all those things. I mean, what a beautiful saying to say, love thy neighbor. It would be nice if it continued and said, how? I mean, who is most likely there to agitate you? If somebody 7 miles away turns on their lawnmower, it's not going to bother you. But when the neighbor does, and if there is something going on, the neighbor's antennas will be out to find out when you are taking the nap, and then that's when everything will happen. So here's the world chasing. It's not just one scripture, it's one after another saying the same things. Don't do this, don't do this, don't do this, this is not good, this is not right. And people are, yes, we should follow this. We should follow this, we should follow this, we should follow. It's like, here we are. Here we are. What is going on? People are given guns. Go kill. And when they do, you're a hero. And somebody gets the same idea at home, and it's like, you're a criminal. And what is said in the newspapers? Oh, he killed these innocent people. Well, when you go out to a foreign country, the chances of you knowing these people are zero. But who is it? You don't know them. You're pointing a gun out there. And somehow, it's okay. And people argument, but, they say. I say, you know, we shouldn't kill people. But, blah, 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 but they have an argument which legitimizes what they are doing, even though they know it is wrong. And how does the argument be? But don't you think? And you feel like saying, I do. Why don't you try it? Try thinking for once in your life. The value of human being, finished. What are you? You're nothing. Crown of creation? Forget it. A pain in the you know where? Yes. For everybody. For everybody. The billions and billions of years it took to finally put you on the face of this earth. Evolution, after this, 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 after this. People say, no, there's not evolution, you just they think that if you believe in any other way that you came here, you don't believe in God. I believe in God. In fact, I know God. I feel God. Unfortunately, or fortunately, my God doesn't have two arms and legs and a calendar and a schedule and a clock. And my God does not live in some planet somewhere, but my God lives in my heart, as does yours. lives in you, in your heart. That's what makes life special. That's what makes it absolutely, as the English would say it, brilliant. Brilliant. But what is the world doing? That door. I'm looking for you to come through that door. Turn within. Do experience a joy that is so simple that it is profound. Turn within and experience an understanding that is so simple that it is profound. Why is it so profound? Because it is complete. There are answers to questions in this world that inspire more questions. And there is an answer within that answers all questions. Perfection is not complicated. Perfection has to be simple. Simple. You take a look at water. What can it not do? What can it not do? Oh, it can be the gentlest thing falling on your body, refreshing you, especially if you've been traveling and traveling and traveling and traveling. Get into that shower. Ah, the gentleness of it, unparalleled. I mean, it could be nothing else. You know, oil wouldn't do it. Just that water as it flows through, takes, refreshes, rehydrates the skin, takes away the dead cells, the dryness, just feels like, ah. So gentle. In another place, it's cutting steel with precision unparalleled. Same water. And its destiny to go back and be as it was. Even when it is frozen, and it stays frozen for not 1 year or 2 years, but thousands and thousands and thousands of years. I saw a glacier, and you just see. You look at it like nothing is moving. And then all of a sudden, huge noise and big waves and a big chunk of that ice, that glacier, comes loose, plunks in the water, and slowly disappears. Wow. When I saw that ice falling, I realized that cycle that just got completed was waiting to be completed thousands and thousands and thousands of years ago. Would you like patience redefined? That water has patience. Oh my God. That water has patience. Unbelievable patience. Flowing and flowing in the most difficult of situations. This year, 2013, has been a very interesting year for a lot of people. And when I say interesting, I don't mean it nicely. And it has been more than once when I have said, "What a year." And my God, what a year it has been. I have seen things this year that is like, wow. Amazing. And I don't mean that nicely. And yet, I have seen the weak become strong. And I have seen the strong become weak. I have seen people lose everything. And I have seen those who had lost everything gain everything. What a year. Those high and mighty, one flick, gone. And those who were weak found a strength. Have you found your strength this year? Did you? Or were you the high and mighty that gets swept under the rug? I hope not. I have seen people lose everything. The most dear one, the most precious one. And I have seen the very ones find the love forever, the timeless love. That's what this year has been. Hard for some, transforming for the others. And regardless of whatever, no status quo shall remain. Change, 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 change. And when I felt that change all around me, I mean, just really felt it all around me. It was easy to give into it. Easy to say, wow, too much. And then to find the unchanging inside again. The rediscovery. See, when you are in love with somebody, it is never ever like you have met this person before. Being in love is always fresh, always different, always new. And when you're not in love anymore, you've seen the same person again and again and again and again and again. There's a couplet from Kabir. Now, most of you have heard me talk about Kabir and so on, and sometimes I say, you know, yeah, he was a poet. He wasn't really a poet. He understood something. He felt something. He felt that peace. He understood that understanding. And from that, he wrote. So it's a big difference. I have seen poetry that is like, what? It rhymes and everything, but you go, nothing profound. You know, I've read poetry, there were the daisies dancing, and my heart was romancing. So this is what Kabir said. I'll first say it in Hindi, the couplet, the way it is. So, man ke bahut tarang hain, chin chin badle soye. Ek hi rang mein jo rahe, aisa Birla koye. See, some of you who understand Hindi, they go, yes, that's cool. Now I'm going to translate it. So you're getting a triple translation. You're getting it from Hindi to English, English to Spanish, Portuguese, whatever. The mind has many colors, constantly changing. Many twangs. Continuously, at night, at day. Sometimes it is doing this, sometimes it is doing that, sometimes you're thinking this, sometimes you're thinking that, sometimes you want to do this, sometimes you want to do that. Many colors, many twangs, change, change. But, Kabir says, the one who remains only in that one color doesn't keep changing is very rare. Rare. All of us? Can you imagine if the next iPhone or the Samsung Galaxy, the next one, could read minds. You know how much trouble you'd be in? I mean, there I see, you know, people all just sitting there. And in Europe, it's very popular, and this kind of popular in America too, and people sit down on the street side cafe with their coffee, looking out. Somebody walks by you with an iPhone or a Galaxy. What do you think about? What do you think about? When all those colors start changing, do you start changing with them? That's a problem. I mean, okay, if the mind is going at it and you're going, I want this, you have had too much coffee or whatever. Okay. You are going with it? Oh my God. I'm destroyed. My life is over. People have said that to me. And I've looked at them and said, why? Oh, but I have nothing. Why? Because something inside went, it's over. And you went, it's over. After all, you're the independent thinker, right? You're the smart, clever, independent. It's over. One day, you're sitting there having your coffee, and this girl walks by, or this guy walks by. Give me a number, give me a number. No. I've been rejected. All the colors keep changing, and you keep changing colors, and now what do you look like? A chameleon. But there is a color. The color of peace. The color of joy. The color of surety. The color that understands that this breath is the most profound gift that I could be given. How many of you have thought at times that you are the most unfortunate person on the face of this earth? Come on. How many of you have thought, why does this only happen to me? Is it my stars? Why me? Wow. Heavy stuff. I tell you this from my experience, my friends. That is the time to remember how fortunate you are. That is the time to remember. I want to be only in one color. I don't want to keep changing these colors. That is the time to remember how important my happiness is to me. That is the time to remember how each breath that comes into me is the most divine blessing. I say this to you from my experience. From my experience. And in understanding that, in knowing that, in accepting that, that was it. That was it. Darkness has a flaw. And you must learn how to exploit this flaw. Exploit. Take advantage of this weakness that the darkness has. You know what it is? It cannot stand light. It's this weakness. It's this weakness. Open the doors of that light that dwells in your heart and chase and just watch it disappear. And know to be thankful every day. To be every day. In that understanding, every day, to have the objective as clear as it gets, I am not going to let these eyes make me blind. I will see. I will see. When it gets cold this winter, when it gets cold this winter, open the doors and let that light warm your being. Outside is easy, just turn up the thermostat. Inside, there's also a thermostat. Feel that warmth. Feel that freshness. Feel that joy. Don't be so gloomy. This may be the shortest day, and this may be officially the start of winter. But as it always is, in the big drama, warmth is afoot. This is true. Now, tomorrow, a little bit longer. And then a minute here, a minute there, and a minute there, at the tilt of this earth, the tilting has begun. It has begun. And as this drama has played out on the face of this earth for billions of years, 4.5 billion years, it'll play out again. And sure enough, the days will keep getting longer and longer and longer and longer and warmer and warmer and warmer. And before you know it, little buds on those trees that have stood silently without their leaves will start weaving their cloaks again. And in their magnificence, they will bring out their flowers and the colors. So once again, that all that that seemed so barren will not be. Whether they change their colors or not, don't you change your color. Stay with your color of clarity. Stay with your color of understanding. Stay with your color of that reality. Stay with that color of that beautiful, profound thing that is inside of you. And you will be the evergreen that does not change its colors. That is what it can be. What will next year bring? To some, uncertainty. They will be the good days, they will be the bad days, as they were this year, as they were last year. Everybody that is sitting here will be 1 year older. This is what will happen. This is the drama that has been playing out on the face of this earth for 4 billion years. I did a ratio, 4 billion years, and if a person lived 100 years, what is that time ratio? And basically, it boils down to that. Just a tad less than 1 second. For as long as the earth has been here, 4.5 billion years, 4 billion years, you living 100 years would be, and that's too much, just a little shy of that. Unreal. Unreal. That's stupid. I mean, that's life. Gone. 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 That irks you a little bit, doesn't it? Like, You change your color. Don't. Because this is what you need to know. This is the knowledge you need to know. Of being able to be in touch with that reality that is inside of you. See, that's not going anywhere. Can't. And right now, you are the flower, and that reality is the thread. And that reality has threaded through you, and you are part of a garland called a garland called life. The thread will go on. The flowers will wilt. And the flowers will be removed. And new flowers will be put. And the dance of life. Not forever. Even that has its limit. But the dance is right now. Dancing. It's happening. So, are you dancing? Every day? Do you feel like a garland? Do you feel like a garland? Because that's what you are. And if you don't feel like a garland, and if you're not feeling like dancing the dance that is happening, then something is very, very wrong. Very, very wrong. And all you have to do to make it right is see the obvious. See, the world thinks this is the obvious. When they know it's not the obvious, I mean, I was talking to somebody yesterday and I said something and then I started thinking about it. They're building these new buildings, like they're building one in Shanghai. They built the Petronas Towers in Malaysia. Super tall buildings. Could they have built these buildings in 1829? It's an interesting question. Because it's not like a spaceship came down to Earth and brought the materials. Actually, all the materials that they are using to build these buildings already existed in 1829. But the people didn't know how to put them together. The new kind of concrete, the new kind of steel, the new kind of technologies. This did not exist. This is the human learning. And they call this the obvious. Ta-da! No, it's not ta-da. 20 years from now, they might come up with a material that That building is built for that special purpose. Hit a button and it changes itself to an entirely new function. It's entirely possible. All you have to have is just a little imagination. So you don't have to have these square buildings. You don't have to have these apartments that are limited in size. You need a little extra space because you're having a party, no problem. Boom! And then the party is finished, boom! Because there is a distinct advantage to having a smaller space if you don't need a bigger space. Less cleaning to be done. And if you're the owner, living in that and you don't have somebody coming in, it's much better. You know, a lot of people say, oh yeah, more bathrooms the merrier. No. Less bathrooms the merrier. But just the right amount is the best. I mean, look at it, you know. Not too long ago, I remember owning the first digital camera that Apple made. And it was so different. It took pictures, garbage. And I remember looking at one of the pictures from the first electronic camera and I said, my God, this is never going to replace the film. I used to take a lot of pictures with film. Film was so much superior. Now, forget it. The digital pictures that you can now take completely outdo film. No comparison. This is obvious? No, this is changing. Ah, but one thing that doesn't change. So I say something from Kabir, and it feels like he just said it. Not aged. When I talk about the heart, it sounds like you have never heard it before, even though you have heard it 1,000 times. Because it is the most interesting. Joy is the most interesting. Peace is the most interesting. Love is most interesting. Clarity is most interesting. Light is most interesting. Let that water of understanding fall upon you and refresh you every single day. Every single 600 years ago, somebody stood under that water and felt the same feeling as I just described to you a few minutes ago. Just soft, cleansing, and refreshing. And this 600 years ago, this human being, technology, nothing. iPhone, furthest from the mind. Digital camera, furthest from the mind. Autonomous cars, furthest from the mind. but felt the same thing as a person would feel today. Exactly as you would feel today. Because some things don't change. Be refreshed. Be refreshed. Knowledge also has a funny quirk. I'm talking about, physical knowledge. Has a funny quirk. It can be in a book, and you can buy the book, but it automatically won't go into you. You have to read the book. Then it may go into you, but that's it. The transferring, simply by buying the book, the transference doesn't take place. Same thing with also the knowledge of the self. Simply by having it, nothing happens. It's when it is practiced. That's when it makes sense. I have a violin. Long, long time ago, my wife gave me this violin. I didn't know how to play it then. And I don't know how to play it now. And I didn't even know where this violin was, except I have so much garbage at home. I finally decided to get rid of it, and so we were looking through all the stuff, and I came across the violin. I did not throw the violin away or put it up for sale. I still have it, but I still don't know how to play it. Now you think that I've had it for more than 30 years. Something would have happened, right? But you see, I never practiced it. I never played it. I never learned it. So many people in this world are the same way. They think if they can buy the violin and keep it around for long enough, they will know how to play it. So what they do? What do? They talk about peace. Talk. Tuck, 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 tuck. Sorry, it doesn't work like that. I could have all this time, 30 years, I could have just chanted violin, 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 have a picture of Mozart. Burn incense in front of it, have Vivaldi, to have the Vivaldi Arthi, it's like, yes, with the flame, the fire, the incense, and have all the music, everywhere, look at this music, it's so wonderful, it's so, the glory to this music, and how incredible it is, how divine it is. I still wouldn't know how to play the violin. So, just having ideas about peace does not come. Peace has to be felt, and the peace not in somebody's concept, in somebody's idea of peace. That's not what you need to feel. You need to feel the peace that is inside of you. Somebody asked me, so what's so different about what you say? Other people say the same thing. And I'm the first one to admit it. Oh, I'm sure there are speakers who are much more eloquent than I am. Who can say things more wonderfully than I can ever do. But my strength is not the words. My strength is the peace itself. That's my strength. I don't go around talking about water. I have a way. For those who are thirsty, I can give them water. When you have a person like that in your life, stay thirsty, my friends. If you don't be thirsty, because it'll be a torture. That's the difference. That's the difference. That's the difference. I know Christmas people will have big dinner, family dinner, and people will on purpose not try to eat so they can be hungry. That's because you know the dinner is coming. But if you didn't know where your next dinner is going to come from and then you find yourself hungry, that's torture. That's painful. So, be in peace. Enjoy your holidays. They say holidays. I know the kind of holiday you need. You need a holiday from all that whole system that tells you to enjoy the holidays. That's the system that's made every holiday a working day. Because it should be. Understanding, clarity, recognizing, embracing, every day. Yes, every day. People go, every day? Which day would you reject? Let me put it in context. When you're going to live this long, which day would you like to reject? Which one? To me, this is already too fast. I don't have enough. I don't have enough days to make mistakes. I would like to have a lot of days to make mistakes. I don't. I can't afford to just... This is it. This is your life right now. Your life. In slow motion, the finger has started to move. Is it bad news? No. It's good news. The good news is you're alive. You're alive. Just... People go, oh, that's so depressing to hear about death. I agree. So fall in love with life. If you are depressed by death, fall in love with life. Then you wouldn't have to worry about it. Because you're this everywhere you, when you're in love, what happens? You see that face everywhere, right? Everywhere you go is that person. Isn't that what they say? In love? Be in love with life. See this life manifesting. Everywhere. Everywhere that you are, that you go. Be content. Be thankful. Be thankful. Be thankful. I know there's a lot of parents. They have to give their children gifts. They're going to go shopping and buy and buy and buy and buy and buy. It's up to you. But I know there is a gift you can give your children that will last them for the rest of their life. And you know what that one is. That look. That look from a father. That look from a mother. Expressing in the truest terms the adoration you truly have for that child. Love. And the gratitude that that child is in your life. Always remember. Always. 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 Now, in a way you've been corrupted. So you give gifts. Corruption. It's like, I give you this, and you give me, you know, this. So I give you this gift, and in return, I want you to be nice to me. See, corruption goes so deep, it's amazing. It's the same thing with God. I give you this if you give me this. I will give you my devotion if you make me a billionaire. I'll give you my devotion if I can have that woman. I'll give you my devotion if I can have that man. I mean, my God, take a shower, please. This is getting stale. On and on, the same. I mean, this is what they were doing in 1829. 1729. And Rudolph the caveman still doing that same thing. And people are still doing it. And it's like, oh yes, we're in 2013. Then act like it. Act slightly civilized. Civility is not out there. Civility is in you too. If you do not respect yourself, you can never respect another person. Never. Have you learned to respect yourself? You don't even know what that means. I mean, most people don't even know what that means. When I say that, you know, I watch the audience. I've got pretty good eyesight. I had my eyes checked out last year, I think it was. And the guy said, you have eyes of an 18-year-old. So I was like, great. So I can see. And when I say, respect yourself, I can see the audience going, What does that mean? Peace is inside of you, huh? That's where it's going to come from, right? No, it's not. Understand one thing. Peace never left you. You left peace. And to this day, peace is with you. You are the one who ignores clarity. You are the one that ignores the truth. You are the one who ignores the simplicity. simplicity does not ignore you. The rest, always up to you. So I wish you a happy new year. And in fact, I've got some greetings on the premrawat.com. It's besides the fact that it says coming soon. And when it says coming soon, I mean it is coming soon. I have no idea when, but it says coming soon. And that's meant coming soon. But, you know, that's going to be, I'm very excited about that website. Even though not a single word has been written for it, except for what you see on that page. Coming soon is how it started. Nothing has been done. And only a few days left. And I'm sitting here. And a few days left till the end of the year, and coming soon is right. But, you know, I'm very excited about it, and I think it'll be a fun site to be at. So enjoy yourself. Be in that place. Experience that peace. Experience that joy, because that is possible for you to do. Thank you very much. And good night, and I hope I'll see you next year, soon.